Hello children, welcome to another class of Standard 8 Mathematics. Let us continue with our chapter Area and Perimeter. In our today's class, we are going to learn to find area of a new shape, that is quadrilateral. So let us see how to find area of a quadrilateral. Here we are. Let us consider a quadrilateral ABCD. Now we can divide the quadrilateral ABCD into two triangles, triangle ADC and triangle ABC. If you see AC, a diagonal of this quadrilateral is a common base for both the triangles. H1 is height of ADC and H2 is height of ABC. We already know how to find area of a triangle. So if we find area of triangle ADC and area of triangle ABC, combined we will get area of quadrilateral, right? So draw a diagonal AC which divides a quadrilateral into two triangles. So area of quadrilateral will be equal to area of triangle ADC and area of triangle ABC. Now what is the formula to find area of triangle? Half base into height. So half AC is the base and H1 is the height, plus half AC is the base and H2 is the height. Now if you use distributive property over here, we can take half AC common. So let us take half AC common, H1 plus H2. And here we are with the formula of quadrilateral to find area of a quadrilateral. Half AC is the diagonal into sum of the perpendiculars on the diagonal. So let's solve some problems. This problem is problem number 1 from exercise 11.4. Find the area of quadrilateral ABCD in which AC is 36 cm, BL and DM are perpendiculars from B, and D to AC, whose lengths are 16 centimeters and 18 centimeters respectively. So we are having all the quantities that we require to find the area of quadrilateral. What is the formula again? Yes, you are right. Area is equal to half AC into DM plus BL, that is perpendiculars on the diagonal. So let us substitute. Half AC is given as 36, correct? That is the diagonal. And the two perpendiculars are 18 centimeter and 16 centimeter. So that brings us to, we can use cancellations. So 2 ones are 2. And 36, so 2 18s are 36. So we are having 18 multiplied by sum of 18 and 16 is 34. So 18 into 34. So the answer is 612 centimeter square. Now let us take one more problem. Pratima made a triangle ABC in which AC is the base, that is 10 centimeter, altitude, that is height, is 3 centimeter, triangle DEF in which DE is 10 centimeters and altitude is 6 centimeters. So let us imagine this. We have one triangle ABC, AC is the base, this one, and height is 3 centimeter. So height is from here, from B to the base. Okay, and there is another triangle, which is triangle DEF. The base is DE, 10 centimeter, this one, and height is 6 centimeter, that is from F. Okay, then she joins the triangle such that A coincides with D here and C coincides with E. So she joins the triangle. Let us try joining the triangle. Yes, we have got A and D coinciding and C and E coinciding. So we got a quadrilateral. And we have to find the area of this quadrilateral. We already know height BC over here. We already know this height from B. How much is that? 3 centimeter. And we also know height from F, which is 6 centimeter. So diagonal AC is also given 10 centimeter. So easily we can find using the formula. But since they have given it separately as a triangle, let us go as per Pratima only. Okay, so triangle ABC, AC is given, H is equal to 3 centimeters. So area of this triangle will be half base into height, that is half AC into H1. AC is 10 centimeter, H1 is 3 centimeter. So we can do cancellations here, and answer is 15 square centimeter. Now let us find area of the next triangle DEF. DE is 10 centimeter. It's already given. H is, and height is 6 centimeter. Correct. So area is half base into height, that is DE into altitude, that is H2. So half 10 into 6 centimeter, the answer will be 30 square centimeter. Now we have to combine both, correct? So area of the quadrilateral formed will be 30 plus 15 plus 30, which is equal to 45 square centimeter. Just to give some supporting statements, we have written, we have on joining triangle ABC and DEF such that AC and DE coincides and a new quadrilateral is formed. So the area of quadrilateral is 45 square centimeters. Very easy, isn't it? Now let us go for this problem, question number 3 of the same exercise. Find the length of the diagonal AC in the adjoining figure if area of quadrilateral is 35 cm square. Now here if you see, we have AC as the diagonal whose length we have to find out. We already know area is 35 cm square and the heights are already given, 1.8 and 5.2. So very simple, if we use area of quadrilateral's formula, we can easily find diagonal, because area of quadrilateral will have diagonal and the perpendicular heights in it. Correct? So what is the formula for area of quadrilateral? Half diagonal into H plus H1 plus H2, that is perpendiculars to the diagonal. So let us substitute those. 1 upon 2 into AC into 1.8 plus 5.2 equal to 35. 1.8 plus 5.2 is 7. 5.2 plus 1.8 would be 7, correct? So here 5.2 plus 1.8 will come to 7. So AC will be equal to, 2 is in the denominator, it will go to the numerator, transposition. So 35 into 2 upon 7, use cancellation, 7 ones are, 7 fives are. So AC is equal to 10 centimeters. So since area of quadrilateral is given, we can use a formula to find the diagonal. So length of the diagonal is 10 centimeters. Now here we are having one figure in which I can see one rectangle, one trapezium and another rectangle. So to find the area of this given figure, we will find individually area of this rectangle, which is 2 multiplied by 4. This one trapezium, which is half into height, which is 1 meter they have given us, into length of the parallel sides, sum of length of the parallel sides. So this side will be 5 centimeter and this side will be 2 meters. So this will be 5 plus 2. And the third one again is a area of a rectangle, so 5 multiplied by 3, that is length into breadth. So individually we will find the areas of each figure and then we will add it to get the area of the total figure. So let us start. Rectangle, first figure is rectangle, length is 2 meters, breadth is 4 meters. So area of rectangle, we will take it as figure 1 A1, 2 into 4, which is 8 square meters. Okay, the second figure is trapezium. So here parallel sides are 2 meters and 5 meters, as I said. The opposite sides are equal, so this is 5, and this opposite sides are equal, so this is 2. So parallel sides are 2 meters and 5 meters. So we will use a formula, half into height into sum of the parallel sides. So that comes to 7 divided by 2, which is 3.5 square meter. And the third figure is again rectangle with length 5 and breadth 3 meters. And that gives us 15 square meter. So the area of the figure would be A1 plus A2 plus A3, which is 8 plus 3.5 plus 15, which is 26.5 square meter. So this way we can find the area of any parallelogram, any polygons now. Now if you see over here, we are having two trapeziums, correct? And we have heights also given. We have length of the parallel sides also given. So we can easily use formula for area of trapeziums and find the area of the two trapeziums and add them to get the entire figure. Correct. So trapezium 1 would be height is 10 meters and parallel sides are 21 meters and 30 meters. So what's the formula? Half into height into sum of parallel sides. So height is 10 meters, sum of parallel sides 30 plus 21. Here you will cancel 2 ones are 2 fives are. So 51 multiplied by 5, which comes to 255. Area of trapezium 2, here height is 11 meters, sides parallel sides are 30 and 20. Substitute in the formula, half into height into sum of parallel sides. So half into 11 into 30 plus 20 plus 20 comes to 50. 11, 2 ones are and 50 cut 25, correct? So 11 into 25 is 275. So half into 11 into 50. So this cancellations can be done. Correct. So area of total area of the figure will be equal to A1 plus A2, which comes to 530 square meters. So this way we can easily solve, we can divide the given figure into known known figures, and using the formula we can find the area, and then total we can find the sum of all the figures to get the required area. Let us go for this question. Problem number C from the same exercise. So here, if you see, we can see many known figures whose formulas we already know, and we can find the area very easily. For example, if you see this triangle, we can find, because base is 2 meters and height is 3 meters, we can easily find its area by half base into height. Again, there is this triangle, where base is 4.5 and height is 4. So we can use the formula to find the area of this triangle also. We can use this also. 5 is the base, 3 is the height. Correct? And we can easily find out area of this triangle also, because 2 is the base and 6 is the height. Or you can take other way around. 6 is the base and 2 is the height. So we can use formula to find the area of this 4 triangles first. Then we can take areas of this trapezium. Here this side is parallel to this side, and this can be taken as the height. Correct? This can be taken as the height. So that we will find area of this trapezium. And here we can see this is also a trapezium, because this is 3 meters, this is 2 meters. Both are parallel to each other. Correct? So height would be 4 meters over here. So this trapezium. This way we can find the area of the entire figure. So first we will go for triangle. Let's name these points. Let this be a P. P. This be Q and this be R. Okay. So let us start. First triangle will be ABO. Okay, here O is there, ABO. Okay, B is 2 meters. So if you can see that the base is 2 meters and height is 3 meters, correct? Base is 2 meters and height is 3 meters. Okay, so half base into height. Substitute and get the answer, 3 square meters. Fine. Let us go for the second triangle, that is AFR. In AFR, if you see, the base is 5 meters, that is this one. This one. And height is 3 meters. So let us substitute in the formula, half base into height, half into 5 into 3. So here this will come to 2.5 and answer comes to 7.5. Then let us go for the next triangle, CPD. In CPD, if you see, the base is 4.5 meters and height is 4 meters. Correct? So half base into height. Again, we get the formula. 2 ones are 2 twos are 4 and 4.5 into 2, 9 square meters. And the next comes DEQ. DEQ, the height is 2 and base is 6 meters. So we get over here 2 ones are, 2 threes are, so answer is 6 square meters. Correct? So now let us go for the trapeziums. Now the first trapezium that we will look into is BCPO, that is this, correct? So here the parallel sides are 3 and 4. Okay, the parallel sides are 3 and 4. We have to find the base. Now if you see this base, this particular part of the base, we can easily take it by 5 minus 2. This is 4. And this small part which is there can be taken by 6 minus 4.5. So accordingly, we will get our OP, which is base of the trapezium, 8.5 meters. And once we know the base, we can use formula of half into height into sum of parallel sides. We know the parallel sides already, 3 and 4. Correct? So 29.75 after calculations. So this, if you see, it comes to half into 8.5 into 7. So 7 to 1s are, this is 3.5. So 8.5 multiplied by 3.5 will give us 29.75. Okay. And the next part would be the next trapezium. Here also we have 3 centimeters and 2 meters as the parallel sides. Correct? And the height is 4 meters, which is perpendicular to the bases. So this trapezium will give us area half into 4 into 3 plus 2, where we can 5 into 2 is 10 square meters. So total area will be area of triangle ABO plus AFR plus CPD plus DEQ plus trapezium BCPO and trapezium EFRQ. And that will give us the final answer after derivation, 65.25. So not so difficult, very easy problems based on the quadrilaterals. Now let us see how to find area of this particular polygon. Now if you see here, we can see number of rectangles over here. So if you close this figure over here, then we get a rectangle, this one. If we close the figure here, we get one more rectangle over here. If we close the figure over here, we get one rectangle over here. Then we can take this rectangle. And again, we can take this rectangle. So total I can see 5 figures over here, 5 rectangles, and we can find area of that because all the lengths and breadths are given. So then we can add all these areas to get area of the given polygon. Let us start likewise. So area of figures, we know that area of rectangle is length into breadth. Let us use it to the different rectangles that we have divided this given figure into. So figure 1 will be the length is 6 meters and the breadth is 2 meters. So 6 into 2 is 12 square meters, the blue one. The second figure that you see, we can see over here that this is 4 meters and this is 2 meters. So total the length will come to 6 meters. Correct? 6 meters, 4 plus 2. And breadth of course is given as 2 meters. So this will be 6 into 2, 12 square meter. The red rectangle that you are looking at, this is 6 meters and this is 2 meters, so total 6 plus 2, 8 meters. Correct? This will come to 8 meters. So the figure third will be 8 into 2. The breadth is already given as 2 meters. So 8 into 2, 16. Figure 4, this is 4 meters into 2 meters, so total 8 meters, square meters area. And this, as we know, 6 plus 2, 8, correct? So this length is 8 and this is 2. So that would be 8 into 2, 16 square meters. So we have found area of all 5 rectangles. Let's add them up to get the area of the polygon. So 12 plus 12 plus 16 plus 8 plus 16, that comes to 60 square meter liters. So it is so simple. Just looking at the various polymers, we need not worry. We will just divide it into the figures whose formulas we already know, and we will add up to get the area of the given figure. So in today's class, we have seen area of quadrilateral, how to find out area of quadrilateral, and also area of various polygons by dividing them into the figures of known formulas. Okay, thank you, children. Have a nice day.